Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1381, quarter hours. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in by Michael. Michael has a large data set of events that have happened, and it's in date time format. He's trying to create a pivot table from that and wants to group that up to quarter hours. So insert pivot table, click OK. We'll put the dates down the left-hand side, the count there. We want to group that field. Okay, so normally we come here to group field, and you see, very frustrating. If we would choose only days, they could say the number of days, but that is the only one of these that works. If we would choose, for example, minutes, that's grayed out. You can't say roll it up to 15-minute increments or anything like that. So there's really no good way to do this. If we do hours and minutes, it's going to be every minute instead of quarter hour. Of course, hours will just give us hours. So let's think about how Excel stores dates. Excel stores dates as a fractional portion of a day. So noon is 0.5, 6 a.m. is 0.25, and so on. So if we had 24 hours in a day and we want to break it into quarter hours, we can just do a simple little multiplication here. See if there's 96 quarter hours in a day. And since each day is equal to the number 1, if we do 1 divided by 0.96, that is the answer. All right, so that's how many portions of a day would come down to quarter hours. So let's see if we can build a little formula over here back in our original data set that will use that number. Just copy it over here and paste. All right, so I'm going to call this quarter hour. And the formula is going to be equal mod of that date, comma 1. What's that going to do? That's going to take off any whole days and give me just the time. All right. And then I'm not going to use round. I'm going to use something called mRound. mRound, I think that stands for like multiple round, round to a certain multiple. And normally, I would use this round up to the nearest 5 or 10 or something like that. But very interesting, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that number, 1 divided by 96. Actually, 1 divided by 96, that way I don't have to worry about that other cell out there. And bam. All right, now let's see if this actually worked perfectly for us. I'm going to format that column, Control 1. We'll go into time. Yep. Actually, let's do one that shows the seconds. Click OK. And you'll see that we've perfectly rounded everything now to the nearest quarter hour. Now, by the way, Michael had asked, hey, would PowerPivot do this? And while PowerPivot adds a lot of date and time intelligence, and when I actually looked, it added a lot of date intelligence, not a lot of time intelligence. You'd have to do the exact same thing in PowerPivot. So PowerPivot could solve it, but using this exact same method. So let's just stay here. We'll get rid of our other pivot table. Actually, I didn't need to do that. I could have just refreshed, but insert pivot table. Click OK, and now we can put quarter hour in row labels and count in values, and we get to see how many items occurred in each quarter hour. All right, so Michael, I know you were looking for something better, something built into pivot tables. Unfortunately, it's just not there. Power Pivot doesn't add it either, but this formula here, the equal M round with mod, and rounding to the nearest 1 divided by 96 will get you back to the quarter hour. Okay, well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. I want to thank Michael for sending that question in. We'll see you next time for another netcast.